Hello friends, this is Supriya. Welcome back to my channel Biology Reader. Today in this session we will study the qualitative test for lipids. So friends, let's get started. Starting with the introduction, lipids are the organic biomolecules which include fats, oils, waxes, vitamins, hormones, etc. The characteristic feature of lipids is that they are soluble in non-polar organic solvent like chloroform and insoluble in polar solvent like water. Lipids are generally hydrophobic in nature as they are water insoluble, but some lipids are amphipathic in nature like cholesterol, glycolipids, etc., which contain both hydrophilic and hydrophobic regions. To identify the presence or absence of lipids in the test sample, we can perform some preliminary and specific test which we call the qualitative test. Qualitative test for lipids is a type of analytical method by which we could determine a chemical or physical property of lipids. The purpose of doing this test is to detect the presence or absence of lipids and to check the reactivity of lipids with the chemical reagents. Solubility test is a common test using which we can check the presence of all lipids based on their solubility in various solvents. To perform the test, we require test tubes, non-polar solvent like chloroform, and polar solvents like ethanol and water. To check the solubility of lipids within these three solvents, take three clean test tubes, then add 2 ml of test sample to each test tube. After that, label the test tubes as A, B, and C. Then add chloroform to the test tube A, ethanol to the test tube B, and water to the test tube C. Then if you shake the test tube A, you could see a soluble mixture because lipids being hydrophobic are soluble in non-polar solvent, that is chloroform. Then if the test sample contains lipids, then it forms a partially soluble mixture with the ethanol, but upon heating, the mixture becomes soluble. At last, lipids are insoluble in water and you could see a film of lipid on the top of water. Translucent spot test is an easy procedure to identify lipids based on the formation of translucent and greasy spot on the filter paper. To perform the test, we need filter paper, lipid or oil sample, water, and dropper. First, take two filter papers and then take oil and water sample. Then add a drop of oil to the filter paper. After that, add a drop of water to the filter paper. After some time, you can see a translucent spot on the filter paper and the test is positive for the lipids. And a colorless spot indicates the absence of lipids and the test is negative. Then saponification test depends upon the saponification reaction in which lipid triglycerides react with alkali sodium hydroxide to give soap and glycerol in the presence of ethanol. To perform the experiment, we require test sample, test tube, alkali NaOH and ethanol. First, add a small volume of test solution to the test tube, then add strong alkali NaOH, then boil the solution in the water bath for up to 5 minutes, and after that add ethanol. If froth appears in the test tube, then lipid is present and the test is positive. And if froth does not appear, then lipid is absent and the test is negative. Sudan test is based upon the binding and solubility of lipids in a nonpolar compound. Sudan dye is a nonpolar compound or reagent, and lipids on reaction with Sudan dye will first bind and take up the color of the dye, forming a red-orange colored solution. To perform the test, we require test sample, test tube, and Sudan dye. First, add 1 ml of the test sample to the test tube, then add a few drops of Sudan dye into the test tube. If the solution turns red in color, then lipid is present and the test is positive, and if the solution is remain unchanged, then the lipid is absent and the test is negative. Then dichromate test is used to detect the presence of glycerol. This test is based upon the oxidation reaction. In this test, glycerol and dichromate ions react to give a brown colored solution. Then in the presence of concentrated nitric acid, the chromic ions reduce into chromous ions or oxidize glycerol by giving a blue color to the solution. To perform the test, we need test sample, test tube, potassium dichromate solution and concentrated nitric acid. First take 2 ml of test solution into the test tube. Then add a few drops of 5% potassium dichromate solution into the test tube. Here a solution turns brown in color. After that, add few drops of concentrated nitric acid into the solution. If the color of the solution turns brown to blue by adding concentrated nitric acid, glycerol is present and the test is positive. and if the solution appears brown in color, then the test is negative. So friends, this is all for today. To know this topic more in detail, you can visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So friends, if you find this lesson useful, do like, comment, share and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos.